Welcome. I'm Suzanne Davidson, Executive Director of the Chamber Music Society of Lincoln Center, and it's obviously always thrilling to have a master class for us to have these fabulous young musicians. We have from Stony Brook and Manhattan School of Music and Juilliard here today, and particularly to have Torleif Thedéen, who is, as David Finkel, who knows a little bit about cellos, described to me, one of the greatest cellists in the world. So for us to have him here to work with these students is really very exciting. We thank all of you for being here and for all the support that you give us all the time. There are a bunch of you in the audience whom I haven't seen since last night. So it's really great that we have that kind of support and community here, and the opportunity to really today understand some of the insights into what makes a performance a great performance. So thank you again for being here, and have a wonderful time.
Beethoven, A major sonata, first movement, or?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. And your names?
I'm Fadi. I'm Phuc.
And your name is?
Deeb.
Yeah, page turner.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Wonderful performance. what ideas do you have when you're starting the sonata on your own?
Beginning.
Yeah. What is your sort of? I mean, it's not about the story, but you could have different. Either you could have some kind of color in mind. You could have some kind of. Atmosphere or character. I mean, it could be different. I'm just wondering how you look at it.
Right, because obviously the opening is the motif that he used for everything else.
Mm.
So I was thinking structure. So something
structure, yeah. Yeah.
Noble.
Mm-hmm, noble, okay.
Can compass the whole sonata.
Okay.
So something bigger.
Yeah, okay.
But still, so like secret.
Yeah, okay, like, good. I think maybe we have so short time now, and also, but I think maybe I would love to work a little bit on basically two things: dynamic range and colors, and a third thing that is connected is density of sound, because somehow, for me, I mean, you play really beautifully. You have beautiful sound and intonation. Everything works basically very well, you know. And also, you have you're a musical person. You know, you play in a musical way, I think. But somehow, generally musical way, but somehow you need to be more particular in your musical ideas and choices sometimes. And for instance, the beginning, in my ears, sounded and then in the when it comes back in the end of open A string, for me it sounds a little bit same tune, and beginning maybe should be less, more like imitating maybe, I don't know, a flute or clarinet or something. You know, it's not opera. Well, opera, you could also, of course, do different things, but nothing against opera. But we have the possibility. You're starting all by yourself. It's a total silence. And I think when you practice, you should not like, but you should wait for the silence and imagine the silence from where the music comes. And then you could, and then suddenly you will not probably be so happy with your first note, huh? Because you hear it in a different way when it comes from total silence. Can we try at the beginning? Okay. Can you do it more with the arm, not to? But more now, maybe it's too much airy, but let's experiment a little bit. That's dense, huh? You can use these colors also. Almost not touching the string, you know. You have all the ranges. So So really work with the speed, the contact point, and of course the pressure as well. Try again. Okay, again, the first note. This is what I mean with a generally nice sound, but it's not specific, you know, it sounds a little bit, it's like you're talking about something that is generally a nice day, but it's nothing that, this has to be the you know, the focus of your attention to find exactly what you want. And you do it differently than I and many others, but somehow it sounds a little bit, that the note, yeah, casual, thank you. Thank you. Very nice. You almost end up in this color. And that will not be so much less than when you play loud. So save. Just introducing something very, as you said yourself, seek some kind of secret. Huh? Don't open up too much. Let's try. Just understating. Can you do the end of the phrase? And imagine that you sort of, you know, you're serving this like amazing plate to Fadi, you know? It's not, oh right, you're here. No, you have to know when you play, that's really that your best friend in the world. You have to give it like that. Beginning, maybe again? Fantastic. Just small details, if I may. I think it has its technical reasons. You're less afraid of the, yes, very calmly with the arm, not too much here. Again. And please, a little bit silence before you start. It was, when you started before, it was some kind of, some kind of expectation, you know, when you leave the silence silent. Sorry to interrupt. When you play it, maybe you do crescendo a little bit earlier than it's written, or? Maybe just wait for the crescendo, and so you go together. When crescendo starts when it should start, I think, is great. But this was noble, beautiful, and humble. You know, it was like you don't have to show yourself here. It's so obvious. It's all silent anyway. We only hear you. Last time, please. Okay. Again, sorry. Was like, work out now.
timbre.
And now crescendo. Can you go a little bit closer to the bridge? Not so shh. Okay, and don't press too much, just use the weight. Exactly. So, I mean, the pressure of the fingers comes here, but not the weight, not weight, like waiting for something, but weight is heavy. And here, of course, you use the fingers. Sometimes you use the fingers too much at the frog, I think. Okay, can you play beginning of Dvorak for me, please? Okay, relax, a little bit speedier bow and closer to the bridge once. And make sure that is. Okay. You have to keep the contact at the dip. Okay, and not, sorry, we're gonna come back to Beethoven, but not so much attack, but not so speedy attack, but ta, not wow. If you do too speedy bow, the bow will do like an airplane, it will lift, you know, if it's too speedy actually. So a little bit slower, huh? Exactly, much better here. Now, of course, when you have more contact with the bow, you need a little bit more vibrato to make it not, but, okay, sorry. Let's go back to Beethoven. From there. Yes, very good. Question. It sounds okay for in my ears, but I'm just questioning whether da ba 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 bum. Why do you do separate bows?
Because it's more slower and if it's slower, it's too cello.
Mm-hmm, okay, okay. You know, when you play on the old instruments with low less tension. You play these kind of bowings, yeah, yeah. They would sound on the more high tension instruments that we have. It sounds ta 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 tam. So somehow you have to do something because now it sounds like too metric and not leggero. I think ta 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 ta. What if you play it? You know, mix a little bit, huh? Yeah. Think about it. I mean, it's a good idea you have, but it doesn't really come out the way I think you want it to. So think about it. Okay. Continue. It's not enough. Not enough power. Also here, you play. Maybe more sostenuto. Not. You know, I need a little bit more because I'm sitting on the side. Maybe it's different out there, but I need a little bit more like contrast. You know, it's all accumulated. Right? It has accumulated a lot of energy from the beginning. That comes out in this dramatic. Maybe from here. Okay, great, great, great. What, much better sound. Can you play as if you don't know what's gonna happen? You know, it's like, we all know, you know? It's almost like, you know, more like all, you know what's going to happen. I know, probably all of you know too. But you know, it has to be lived. You have to live the surprise somehow. It's too planned, huh? Yes. Contact. Question. Nice. Very nice. Little bit behind, huh? You're a little bit behind. Just make sure. It's no problem. You will just listen a little bit more carefully. But and then comes. Do you want to do? Do you want to do twice time taking or? I mean, no. I'm just wondering if you have a, if you.
Well, I guess because before I said to bring out the C sharp.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah.
So I guess a little
bit. It's fine. I'm just wondering what the proportions between the two
by
time.
One
first one more? Okay. Okay, let's try. Nice. I mean, something like that. Sort of. Right? And how are you looking at this scale and the theme dynamically, balance wise? What do you think about it?
I mean, he has more notes, so I wasn't very worried about overpowering.
No?
Because I have few notes.
Yeah. But I mean, in terms of what is more important?
Scale. We decided.
You decided that? Okay. Thank you. Would you mind just trying this idea once? To have, what is the note now? This is the main thing. And then when it goes down, the schedule. So it's sort of, you know, going. So one is a little bit diminishing and one is blossoming a little bit. Not to exaggerate, but can you try once? See what it feels like. Espressive. Think about it. Piano. This is too much. You know it. I know you know it. But just also listen in the present time that you. It's like. Music making is like cooking a little bit. You don't throw in all the herbs and the salt and pepper and then you serve it. You taste all the time, you know, yeah, in order to not scare your guests, you know. So make sure that you always, you both have wonderful ideas, but just make sure that it also sounds the way you want it to. Huh? Can we take from, yeah. Okay. Sorry to be nagging about it, but now it's like, okay, this theme. You have to play supportive with 100% interest, you know, but not covering. Now it was a little bit like, okay, I want to go somewhere else. Long line. Okay, great. You're a very good musician, and you definitely don't have the idea to play the same, huh? But somehow it sounds a little bit too much the same. If you, as a listener, think it's going to be ostinato, then it's something wrong. Huh? So you have to do something with agogic or dynamic or color or, you know. And I think you feel it, but sometimes you play with the fingers and not with the ears, you know. So always play with the ears. Maybe going into this place? Yeah, that's fine. That's very good. Great, wonderful. And another version. Same. Great. It's really, and this is kind of, some people say, yeah, but we do it in the concert, we improvise in the concert. But I think if you practice all the time with and also from a technical point of view, number one, but also imagination is something that needs to be practiced. You know, if you never practiced, imagination, maybe it's the wrong way to express it, but you understand what I'm saying. I mean, you have to practice the ability of imagining different things. So you should never accept, even in practice room, to play exactly the same, you know. But you there was two wonderful ideas, you know. Third one and then go on. Also, many wonderful things. I just would like maybe more legato. And also, this transition, can you think about it as the beginning that you have to it? It's almost like you have to, with the whole audience, you have to sort of change focus to something totally different. And the notes coming in, these notes, they sound a little bit, it's clean and it's nice sound, but it's a little bit, you know what I mean? I think you should find more magic in these notes, actually. Can you just try it? Then I think we have to stop, but just this, yeah. Legato. Very good. Okay. Did you ever practice? Have you practiced the ability of play, vibrating on every note? Can you do it slowly for me once? Yeah, okay, and faster? Yeah, and of course I don't. It's not my idea that you should vibrate similarly on every note. But somehow the technical challenge of being able, not being able actually, if that would be the case, it makes it very difficult to create to shape these notes actually. It goes from open, maybe closing a little bit. Huh? So you just practice these kind of things with the color, and yeah, it's a very short time, but we have to stop. Very, very nice. Thank you. Bravo. Bravo. So we have a Brahms trio now, yes? Great. Thanks. Wonderful. Bravo. Let's bring them in, shall we? Let's bring them in. Okay, names, please. My name is Torleif.
My name is Jisu.
Jisu.
Wanting.
Daniel. Great. First movement of the C minor trio. Thank you. Thanks so much. This is an amazing piece, huh? But the most difficult of the trios, I find. Have you played the other trios? You only play this, huh? Okay. Not only, but you play this, yeah. No, fine. Let's talk a little bit about character, tempo, things like that. How did you... why do you choose this tempo? I'm not saying it's slow or fast, I'm just wondering what is your, let's say, put it like this, what do you want to express in the beginning of the piece?
Initially we started with a faster tempo, mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And as we were rehearsing and playing through and performing this movement, we realized that we just liked that solid, grounded feel.
Mm-hmm. Okay, okay.
It's a very good
explanation, actually, and I think it's a valid explanation. The only thing, when you play very slow, I mean, this is quite a slow tempo from a sort of average point of view, which doesn't necessarily mean so much. But I mean, it's quite a slow. It's much more difficult in a way, which doesn't mean that you shouldn't do it. But if you play so slowly, this tempo, you have to fill it with so much tension and so much, much more, you have to be very, very careful about lines and not losing lines, because you know it's still a very, you know, it's like this movement for me is a little bit like a tsunami. You know, it's like it's just coming like a force of nature. You cannot stop. And somehow, also when you do your retards, it's a little bit like, you know, the tsunami goes a little bit. Yeah, you know, it's. I mean, it's not the whole movement is not like that, but this beginning of this movement with the character has to be more, I think, more like one flow. For instance, you make a big retard under there, somewhere, right? That, I mean, apparently you have decided to do, right? So maybe a little bit less of that, and make sure that you aim for the long line. And it's more important when you play slowly. Can you try beginning? I don't know where to stand now. Okay, I'll be here. Okay. Sorry. Good. Who's giving it? Are you giving it or? Yeah, okay. Could you be much more physical in your, you know, it's like a conductor, you know, it's like, you know, you have to be natural in your own way of moving, of course, but it's a little bit, it doesn't give enough power. And the two of you, equally much, you have to also give it, as an upbeat, even though you're giving it from a rhythmical point of view, you're giving it, all of you, from a character point of view. Okay. Can you do less of this? Because it's from in my ears, it's so slow now. So it's like, it's you're losing the. You know, if you want to slow down something, you want to. Right. I mean, you have like a rubber band. You want to make tension. You know? But if you go so much away from the original tempo, the tension is gone somehow. So maybe not as much. Team, can you keep the chords until the triplet? Team, daddy, daddy. From the beginning. For me, it sounds a little bit. Imagine it's a symphony, and imagine it's the woodwinds, and the answering is maybe the brass or something. It's not, it should be very solid, full sostenuto all the way. And I think you have great attack on the beginning of the chord and great ending of the note, but in the middle it's a little bit foggy. Let's try. And even more power from you. Okay, great. Can you now try? Just try for once. Try once just to go on. Hear what it sounds like. Okay. Sorry. Do you play the first two strings together? I mean, you intend to, right? And before the beat, or?
Slightly.
But you want to play the C on the beat, right?
Yes.
Okay. So how did you analyze how to make the rhythm the sort of tari? Is it tari? Or sorry to turn back to you all of you, but is it tari or ba bam or wah?
I think it's close to the second example.
Tari. I think in your mind you have to know actually what the plan is. Then of course it shouldn't sound like pa-pa, but yada. You have to have the same rhythmical intention. Otherwise the power will get lost a little bit. Try. Go down. Crescendo. Okay, okay, good. So this was total opposite, right? But try to feel the way, you know, it sounds without any retard. So you have the feeling of this tsunami sort of power. Okay, again. And maybe do your version, but a little bit less of the retard. So, I mean, of course, it's a risk with this movement that it becomes like, oh dear, you know. So you have to, of course, create waves within it. Now, of course, it's because of what I've been saying, of course, it's a little bit too much like only muscles, you know. So it's great if you can find waves within it, you know. But maybe I like, from my personal taste, I like it when it's not that slowing down in the very beginning, you know. The tension is a little bit gone now. How is it? Da di da da di da da di da wham, pa pam pa pam. Not too wap. This chord, you know what I mean? Not too short. It needs to be in the context of the. And you write it then on the iPad? My God. And how do you turn the pages? Uh-huh. And you don't have the. No. In Sweden, we don't have cars, you know. Even. Oh, we have. Okay, beginning. Sorry. I'm sorry. It's not enough. More for you. Yes. Much better. How do you want to phrase pa-pam, 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 this place? Because now it sounds very good sound, very good dynamic and power and everything, but it sounds like a little bit digital. How do you want to shape it? Did you talk about it? No, I thought so. It's okay, let's talk about it. Can you play once? Like melodically, once together, and see if some ideas come out of that. Okay, again. Yes, play it. Something happens in your imagination, I think, soon. Okay, is it lorom parom parom tarom paridim parom or parom paridim parom tarom paridim tarom? Maybe you have to. Maybe it's enough just to make like this instead of ending. If you're ending the same way, it's repetitive. Huh? Try the melodical way first. Long line. The way. Right. So when you reach this, it feels strange to play this slowly, but when you reach this spot, you have to have had a development of some kind, you know. So you cannot taram para didin taran 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 didin taran taran taran, you know. It becomes not so musical a way of playing it. So let's try to make again as it's written in tempo, a few bars before maybe. Crescendo! This place. Okay, much better. I mean, you think about it, talk about it, and there's many other options than this. But one option is not possible is this, I think. So whatever you do, just... There are never only one way that composer wants his or her piece to be played. I mean, it's so many ways, but just talk about it. You cannot imitate too much. One line, I think. From there? Okay. But you imitate. It was exactly like twice the same. Huh? La di 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 da da di da ti di da da di da da di da ti di, you know, just try to something, maybe not too much emphasis on the B natural. Also here, the wonderful second finger is working a lot. It's almost more expressive on the. Can you make vibrato on the, what is it, C flat, right? Yeah, okay, but not twice the same. But you don't vibrate on the first, which is, I mean, you just have to be in charge of the choice and not let the fingers choose for you. Yeah. Also the exactly, and you don't have time to, you have to come immediately. Exactly. And then when you can do it, then you can choose. But just make sure that it's not the most convenient finger that decides the phrase, you know? Can we do after the triplets maybe? I know why you don't vibrate on it. You know why? Because you want to check that it's in tune, and then you play on the next note. But you have to just risk it and practice that way. Maybe this line also. Maybe you could start do that, something to create a crescendo. Now you start so loud and that you don't really make a crescendo. Same place. I've been standing in front. Sorry. Very nice. Too fast bows. Little bit more, because it suddenly sounds too much, you know. Also, I'm concerned about can you make the triplets really like a symphony orchestra type, wah ba ba ba, timpani or something. Timpani wouldn't play wah ba ba ba, ya ta ta ta, no. La ta ta ta. Same place. Great. Okay, fine. But can you really take the tempo that piano has? Ya ta ta ya pa pa pam, same. Yes. Yes. Is two. Not too fast, but oh. Try only you. Exactly. And the second, is it G flat? The second G flat, something else, huh? Continuing. And only you. Yes, exactly. Straight from Daniel's place. Actually, you should play. Sorry. Just imagining it as a long line, you know. Because it's too much divided now, I think. If you just can continue this straight on your place. Yes! Okay, fine. It sounds really nice. Bum, ba-dum, ba-dum. Somehow also here, you didn't hear the first lesson, but it's all about not knowing what's gonna happen, or at least not being sort of, yeah, we know this, you know, da-da-da, this, you know. It has to be super special. Dim, ba-dum, ba-dim. So you have to really, in this up, this empty up pause, you have to really fill it with the character somehow. Because it sounds a little bit like... it has to really speak, huh? Maybe a little bit before this place? Nice. You know, sorry, I'm talking too much, but it's so short time. But what is disturbing me is dim, padam, padim, and then you stay with the bow on the string. Dim, dim. Right, I think you need to lift the bow somehow, even though it's maybe a little bit more difficult, but I'm sure you play Dvorak and Paganini and everything, so you can manage, I think. Dam, padam. Like a real breath. Espressivo. Sorry. Okay. Sorry. you know that you play it. All the long notes, you fade away, which can be nice sometimes, but maybe. Next time, continuing. So it show maybe shorter phrase, and then the next time go for a longer phrase. I like the bow lift. Thank you very much. Straight on. Continuing. Thank you. Very nice, very nice. When the piano has, and then you come in right after this, you have to imagine that this note is part of her melody, you know. Then you play, wow, you know, more melodical. Listen for the piano character. Can we maybe try your theme, please? This. Okay, wonderful. I think we have to stop now. But just with this piece, it's very special. It's like A major violin sonata also. It's like the melody just goes back and forth and it, you know. So I think you should take time, the three of you, to look where the line actually goes, because it might start with the cello and then go to the piano and continue in the violin, you know. Because now it's a little bit, too much three separate voices, you know. You really have to create, not all the time, but, you know, quite often, one big line, and listen for the articulation that if you're taking over a melody, that you don't start something totally new. Huh? But it's a big challenge, this piece, and it's I've played it a lot, you know, last 35 years. I think it's still very difficult to really get this, what I'm talking about. But you need to do a lot of work without instruments also. Because when you have your instrument, you're quite often too occupied with, you know, intonation and everything. But you need to look at the score and try to see the line. Huh? Okay, thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Bravo. Is there some water or something?
Sorry.
Glass of water or something? Or mineral water or something?
Yeah, I'll get you some.
Yeah, thanks. Hello.
Hi.
Torleif, what's your name?
To me.
So what was it, Bartok III or? No, I'm kidding. Schubert, right? Schubert, Rosamunde Quartet, A minor. The slow movement they will start with. Do you have a name? A quartet?
Called the
Calliope
Quartet.
Calliope. Okay, Calliope. Good. To run up and down.
Thank you.
Very nice, very nice. I really liked it a lot, and I had the feeling that you love this piece, not only when you sit here, but you have also been loving it through the preparation time, which it's like we spoke about earlier. But you cook and you always you put in the spices, but you always taste, you know, before you serve it. And you have been tasting this very carefully, and you know, I can hear that you have a lot of wonderful ideas. I like interpretation very much. I like the tempo. It's on the fast side, I think, though. And the fast tempo on the fast side is always has a risk that it feels not calm enough. You can play fast tempo with a great sense of calmness, but somehow you have a tendency to play. It's as I don't know what has been going on, but it sounds as if you have been telling each other, "Come on, these eight notes, don't slow down. Just, you know, move them." I don't know if that's the case. Maybe. And it's of course they shouldn't drag. The beginning of the main part of the movement should really I think you should aim for something that is first of all the accompaniment to the first violin should be a little bit like 10 centimeters above ground, right? You have to create something, you know, like something that is accompaniment that is not, and you don't do that. I mean, but sometimes with sound, the timbre and the density of sound, and sometimes the moving together, these kind of things sometimes makes the accompaniment going down, to being too grounded, I think. Maybe we could try just beginning without the violin, the first violin. Okay. So, what is your idea about what is important, or did you discuss this? Or
we're trying to feel it in bar units and two bar units.
Okay.
Feeling a beat hierarchy with
okay.
those.
Okay. Okay. Great. I hear ta ri do ri do ri, and then I hear quite relaxed, and I hear cello. And I was wondering if is that your intention to have three different sort of no okay good. So maybe you should try to, I mean, you listen very well to each other, and you have also the urge and the intention of listening, which is great for chamber music, but somehow you have to be smitten. Is that a word? Smitten by your own by your different sounds, you know. And not stick out too much. Maybe the cello sound is a little bit too much Bloch Shalom or something. So, I mean, it's not at all to that extent, but it's too much in that direction. If you can just be more inside, sort of vibrato sound, and maybe a little bit more present, sort of, I mean, not here, but a little bit more present here. And what if you play just very even, and I mean, now it's just create the beauty in the sound, and not do too much. Let's try, and also balance wise, listen for that. Okay, can we just, if you stop on your first note, and we play the first note together. Okay, let's work on this as a chord. Huh? Intonation is fine, but just find the timbre so you match each other. Just play. Okay. A little bit more espressivo in the second violin. Okay, only cello in the second violin. Okay, and now imagine like the warmest of, like this, just the two of you. Yes, much better. And let's add the viola. Okay, and the viola, sorry, I heard your names out, I already forgotten it. So I will name you as instruments now, sorry. Very sorry about that. Little bit more espressivo, little bit more. Okay, and that was a nice sound, and think about this warm breath. Okay, only violoncello. Okay, how do you find the balance between the two of you? How is the balance in your ears? Yeah. Nice. And with you, this note only. So actually this is, of course, then you play fast notes faster notes, but if you can work on this sort of it's heavenly like sound you have to present. You know, have to. So it's not so bad to just work on this sound world, you know, from only one note's point of view. Can we try again after you've written, and then you move your notes. Okay. great. I do appreciate that you really make a vibrato on the notes, but make sure that it's maybe a little bit closer to the fingerboard with the third finger. Yeah, no. Not to. And listen for balance, all balance. A bit more viola. And maybe this, no, you can sit. What is it? You can have a. You make a button. More like something going all the time, not every note. Again, the three of you. Yes. Okay, great, wonderful. Let's do it with you. But actually, Schubert's music is so fantastic, so you could actually think, yeah, this could also be the composition without the theme, you know, because the theme is sort of built in somehow in the accompaniment. But of course, let's add it. Maybe you do too much, but you're upbeat, you're perfectly together, but your upbeat is making another signal than the character, I think. And it affects a little bit your character also. You think about this. Not one, pom, pom, pom. How is it? Is it written like one long bow, or how is it written?
Yeah, but there are dots under the
thread. Yeah, but don't forget a long bow in your back of your head. Yes, beautiful. Okay, beautiful. How do you want to phrase it from the beginning? How's your idea about phrasing here?
So four bars phrase.
Okay, you didn't really think about that too much, or? I mean, it sounds beautiful what you do, and you have you're a musical person, so it comes out very nice. But you know, I think you have to have maybe a clearer idea, mm-hmm. You know. No, maybe not. You know, you can do it different ways, but just so it doesn't become too flat. Because your sound and your expression is not flat, but the phrase is a little bit on the flat side, I think. Again, sorry. It's almost like you play, but you know. Great, much better. But you guys didn't follow his dynamic. You played as before, like, oh, you have to really be super sensitive. Yeah, that you lack a little bit the line, I think. Okay. Question, much nicer. I mean, you just work on it, you know, and investigate different options. Maybe here also, because this is a phrase that is something new. So maybe don't hit the E as before, you know. That I cannot play it, but this E is not too,
right.
You know, obvious. It should be a little bit more magic, this note. Beginning? Beautiful. Listen, everything is now, but this E is too much for me, too much a knockout, you know. Not T, but at least try this idea, see how you feel about it. Again. Great. So, fine. La di di dum pi dum pa dum pam or ti dum pa dum pam. What do you want? Do you want to go to ti dum pa dum or ti dum pa dum or ti da ta da tam?
I do different in two times.
Okay, and the two different ways are?
So the first time I do da dum da dum da.
Mm-hmm. And the second time?
Ya dum da da.
Okay. Because both times you play ti dum da dum pam actually. So, just to make sure. No, I mean, you know, but just to make sure, because it's the what is it called? The sensation of the weight of the arm. So you have to be careful at the frog that you don't phrase it. I mean, you're a good musician, so but just be careful that you don't become too heavy when you shouldn't. Great E, huh? That's nice. Take from the E. Great, wonderful. It's a fermata, you know? Mm-hmm. And you do it? No, you don't do it.
No.
It sounds like you don't do it, actually. Okay. It's 4 beats, no? 4 beats on the...
Yeah.
Because these fermatas come many times. They come many times right in the movement. So you need to also... What is a fermata? It's some kind of... What do you call it?
Elongation?
Yeah, something like that. So you have to also have a clear idea, you know. Now you're perfectly well together after, but just... listen for when it's time to go on. Same place? So the fermata, in my taste, I mean, I don't know how you feel about it, but it's a way of stopping time a little bit. You know, it's like something, suddenly everything is on hold, you know. So you have to try to create that. You also, maybe sometimes a little bit vibrato on the high note. Same place. Try another fermata? Can we try another way to play the fermata? And not, but you. Like coming out of it, you know. Because this is, I think that you do, it's very sort of healthy start because you want to be together, you know. You play very well together. You could risk it a little bit. Yeah? Right before the cadenza? Before the fermata? Great. Okay. And now the fermata can all of you go with the diminuendo that because you should really follow your diminuendo, I think. You like that, huh? Keep vibrato diminuendo, but keep vibrato. You know, not. But you know, keep the shivering sort of atmosphere. If possible, sorry, if possible, even softer when you start. Okay. Even softer. Okay. Yeah. But I think you have to, you need to practice this. To keep vibrato with diminuendo, because you still do a little bit. You know, to do different fermatas every time. Second time. Too much cello. Sorry. this place. Do you have an idea about? You know what I mean? Up, flat, down, up and down, waves or something. It sounds a little bit too repetitive to me now. Sounds nice, but too repetitive. This part much nicer. It's great. You improvise and you invent things in the moment. Just work like that when you rehearse. Going from this this bar where before we stopped, can you make the change from to light sound? Very power, a lot of density in the sound when you start the bar, and then to loosen it up. Huh? Yeah. Can we try? Maybe like. 3 bars, 4 bars before this, please. And light. This is, you play perfect. Amazing legato. Huh? But you have to lose the density a little bit more, I think. I don't know exactly how it's written.
Like earlier?
Yeah. Okay. Because when you play the E, you have the same density as the E, D, I think. Mm-hmm. So something has to happen with the tension of the sound, I think, sure. on those 4/8 notes. Yes, wonderful. Okay, great. Just a general thing in your ensemble is that I would need a little bit more of what you're sitting with the viola, playing into the piano. And maybe you should consider changing positions, the two of you. Because you project very well, and sometimes in the context a little bit too much, I think, you know. So just be aware, it might be a positioning issue, you know. But just think about it. Maybe where we stopped? 'Place where I wonder. Do you want to be? What do you want to do here? It sounds very sort of. Is that what you want?
I think it changes maybe with each entrance.
Ah, right.
I think is mine is I think more kind of weird. And
ah, okay, that's how you look at it.
More coaxing
it. Okay. I wonder if the sound and the color change would be enough instead of moving the 8 notes too much. I think that would maybe, because it, yeah, I think it comes a little bit out of context too much, I think. Mm-hmm. Can we do it a few bars before this coming into it?
Thank you.
also, you hit this up bow too much. It has to be descending line from, it's, I think it's written like that, or?
Right.
Softer, softer. I think it's nicer this way. I liked it. Maybe your dotted eighth notes are a little bit, a little bit too short. Can we do, coming into this, where we stop? Can all of you catch the color of the, can we play this chord in the middle of the bar here together? Just stop on it on the note. Okay, only this again. Okay, and the three of you with that. Okay, a little bit more espressivo in viola. And more espressivo in the left hand, but not too fast bow in the right hand. Sorry. Okay, and with you? Yeah, exactly. It has to be, because it has been sort of a cold transition period, and here comes super warm. Sadly, so you have to find the warm color on in this bar to come back to home, so to speak. I think we're out of time. But thank you so much. Wonderful.